In this video, we are going to review how SnapGene helps with the plasmid cloning cycle. Here again is our cloning cycle flowchart, highlighting the basic hands-on steps of molecular cloning and the associated decision points. Bookends to this important hands-on work are the important steps of 1. Documenting what you have, 2. Planning how you want to modify it, and 3. Checking your clone for accuracy. In this table, we relist the steps of the cloning cycle. The third column highlights where the cloning cycle integrates with SnapGene. When starting a cloning project, it is likely you will receive some starting material in the mail or from an old freezer box. Hopefully you have a complete sequence. Your first order of business should be documenting your new sequence. The functions for creating DNA files and documenting them are found in the file menu. Your options include creating a new sequence or importing sequences from any number of online databases. Your sequence may come fully annotated, or you may need to spend some time analyzing and annotating it for yourself. The majority of tools used for annotating your sequences are found in these three menus: Enzymes, Features, and Primers. These are all powerful tools that come with many preset options as well as being fully customizable. There are separate tutorial videos at snapgene.com that drill down into these menus. Prior to proceeding, you should be sure that you have received the correct plasmid. All DNA in solution looks the same. Sequence at least part of your plasmid to validate it. Before getting your reagents out at the bench, you need a plan. The planning phase of your cloning experiment is critical to your success. You should be thorough and detail-oriented. You will use the SnapGene Actions menu to digitally clone your product. From this drop-down action menu, you can see the array of cloning techniques you have at your disposal, including restriction and insertion cloning, gateway cloning, Gibson assembly and its close cousin, Hi-Fi DNA assembly, infusion cloning, as well as TA and topo cloning for the capture of PCR products. We will discuss all of these tools in SnapGene in detail in later videos. After you have planned how you will build your construct, you will spend time at the bench, performing the procedures, transformations, and mini-preps. For the time being, at least, SnapGene cannot provide much input into these steps. As you move on to clone verification, the functions found in SnapGene Tools now become essential. As you proceed with clone verification, you will find the tools found under the Tools drop-down menu to be of great use. The best way to verify a clone is to sequence relevant regions and compare the actual sequence to your simulated DNA sequence. For this purpose, you would use the Align to Reference DNA sequence. During the course of your experiment, you may also choose to analyze your clones with a diagnostic PCR reaction or restriction digest. For this purpose, you can use the Simulate Agarose Gel tool to predict your results. In this final table, you can see how SnapGene functions align with your lab bench workflow. The File menu allows you to create DNA documents. The Enzyme, Features, and Primers drop-down menus allow you to add custom annotations to your sequences so that you can create a complete map of the elements in your sequences that are important to you. Under the Actions menu, there is an array of tools which allow you to design and plan your cloning project in silico, allowing you to gear up to manipulate your DNA. Under the Tools menu, Alignment and Agarose Gel simulation options help you complete the crucial final step of validating your molecular clone. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.